Welcome back to Let's Play The Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, Legend of Heroes. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We arrived at the port in Neeri. Finally, after all these tasks and mysteries we had to uncover on the ship, we're finally on solid ground once more. Hello? Marsha says, "Welcome to Menarth. I am Marsha, your immigration officer. Do you have anything to declare?" "Oh, you must be pilgrims. Then you don't have anything to declare, do you?" "Yes, we are pilgrims," Chris says. "How do you know?" "Young children, traveling on their own. Ragpick village in Fothia, isn't it? I read it in the immigration manual. I haven't seen any pilgrims for the last several years, so I thought the custom had been abolished." Yo-Yo says, "No, it's still alive, see?" Yo-Yo shows his silver dagger. "Wow, this is the silver dagger. I'm thrilled to see such a treasure. Thank you. Menarth is suffering from a famine, but people in this town are kind. If you have any problem, feel free to talk to them. I'm sure they'll help you." Anything else to say? "Welcome. Come back anytime if you ever get into trouble. I may be able to give you advice." Okay. I was curious, that just reminded me, the chef gave us a dagger as well. A sailor's knife. Ooh! It's better than what we have, that's for sure. I don't think Chris can use it. Nope, she's like a cleric type. Alright, well, barely used this insight dagger. Now we have the sailor's knife equipped. Hello? Baloo says, "What should we do? We had such a poor harvest, we couldn't even buy seeds for the next year." Yeah, they seem to have fallen on hard times. Hi. Lana says, "What do we do to deserve a terrible crop failure like this?" "I don't know." Oh, is this a local pub? Boar says, "Rumor has it that the bad harvest in Menarth is because of a curse by the Moonlight Witch." You know, we've fought creatures like you, boars. Oh, that's spelled B-O-A-R, though. Mm-hmm. Singing a drink. Jean says, "Witch? It sounds scary. Hick. Come back anytime if you're in trouble. I may be able to give you advice. Whip?" It's supposed to be a hiccup. Neuro. He's a neuromancer. "Hey, this is not a place for kids. We only serve alcohol." Chris says, "That's right. Why do we come here, Yurio?" "Because... I have a question. Your town is suffering from famine, but you've got plenty of alcohol." "We were also out of alcohol until a while ago. The Hawk Talon came in and brought rum. Captain Jilba was so busy. He usually stays here for a drink, but he had to return straight away this time because drift ice was forming. This is a tavern for adults, but you can come back any time if you're in trouble. I may be able to give you advice." Okay. Okay. Dantel says, "Please let me through. I want to have something warm in my stomach." "Are you a shopkeep?" "Yes, Cario the arms dealer says welcome." "What do you have? You have an insight..." Oh, is this... us selling? Wait a second. Buy. Okay, yeah, this is us buying? Oh, this is who it's for. Chris, Yurio, okay. So he's also selling the Insight Dagger. Wooden shield would help out quite a bit. "A simple wooden shield with an iron frame offers little protection." There's the lucky vest we've seen before. Ruby staff is new. "A magic staff with a ruby that boosts the wielder's magic power." We can tell it improves crits, but by how much? Well, I'm gonna sell the insight dagger we have, because we found something better. 50, piers, they call them. Alright, so her attack goes up to 33. What is it now? What is... I guess I'll get it for her. It improves the mat from 27 to something else. So 4 more attack. Mat goes from 27 to... ...29? I'll get it. I mean, we have Pierce, so... And I guess I'll get a wooden shield for Yurio as well. There we go. Well, never had a shield before. Now we do, from 24 to 26. Hopefully that's significant. Show what the range of the stats are. So now we can sell the other staff. Or not. He won't buy that. Okay. This is 50 as well. So this will bring him to 28. I guess we'll get it. But you're breaking my arm here. Up from normal clothing to lucky vest. Will he buy the normal clothing? That's a good question. He will. For 5 piers. Okay. I don't see the other thing here, so... He won't... Yeah, he won't buy a lap staff. Alright. Uh-oh. Nadal says, "Oh no! We must hurry or all jerky will be gone." Gancho says, "Great! We can eat something other than fish." What's going on here? Toreda the trader says, "This boar jerky just arrived by sea. Buy now or it will be gone. Stocks are limited, so only early birds get lucky. Jerky for sale." We are here. I was like wondering who we are in the midst of all this. "Why don't you eat it? It's very tasty," Adel says. Gancho says, "Ships from Folthia always bring food. I can't wait for them to come." Samira says, "I wish we had boars in this country too. Guess we could, you could fight them like we do." "You want jerky too? It's 4 piers, alright?" "Sure." "Thank you. Nutritious boar jerky. It's delicious." Yurio and Chris brought jerky. Yurio says, "This may be from a boar my father caught. You should eat it too, Chris. It's tasty." "I've already finished mine," Chris says. Hem says, we can't eat fish all the time. We get bored. I want to eat meat to my heart's content once in a while. Okay. I can definitely understand that. Oh, what's going on with you? You're in a bad mood. Your pet's stomach is rumbling from hunger. Can we feed it the jerky? No. Shielding food. I guess we need to buy more food soon. I mean, I guess as far as game mechanics go, you only need to feed it when you're gonna be in a battle soon or something, but I hate to have it walk around being hungry like that. Yo-Yo says, wow, it's a river. Are there any fish? Chris says. Whoa! Oh no, the silver dagger! Kai says, I'm sorry, are you okay? Yes, I'm fine, Yo-Yo says. You should be careful, Chris says. Oh no! What happened? No, the silver dagger is missing. What? Oh my, do you think you lost it when you bumped into him? Kai says, I'm sorry, I'll help you find it. Yo-Yo says, don't worry, you're in a hurry, right? I'm sure we'll find it soon. You should go. Are you sure? Yes. Thank you. Then I'll carry on. Sorry. Well, it fell in here. Right in front of us. Chris says we must find the silver dagger. Maybe we could fish for it. Hello? Kilma says, welcome. Feel free to let us know if you're in trouble. Mirio says, or thinks to himself, I guess, we are in trouble, but if we ask for help now, it may look like we're imposing on her goodwill. Alright. Mirio's just too nice. It's a big dead end here. Chris says, Mirio, this is an inn. Since we lost the silver dagger, we can't stay at an inn. Well, can we just talk to people? I want to talk to people, not stay in there. Okay, never mind then. Luna says, hey, travelers, what's wrong? Are you in trouble? No, it's fine, Chris says. We just lost something. We'll look around a little bit more. Let me know if you're in trouble. I will help you. Thank you, Auntie. Auntie? Is that her aunt? No, Yuya, without the silver dagger, we won't be able to continue our journey. So I guess we can't go this way. Okay. Well, I guess... We don't want to impose on her goodwill. Chris says, I don't think we can find it here. Really? We're stuck in this little space. I can't even go up there, can I? Nope. Well, it fell in here. Ugh. Well, wait a second, did you find it? Oh, a mind potion. Yo-Yo says, this river is deeper than I thought. What should we do? Okay. Wait. What'd you find? Where are you? Cure potion. We're stuck in a really small area. It must be lying somewhere at the bottom of the river, Neeri says. What should we do? Chris asks. The river is wide and looks deep. The water also looks cold. Yeah, we're in trouble. Gancho says, Hey! I just heard someone say trouble. Kai says, Yeah, I did too. Okay? Kilma says, Someone is in trouble. We must help. Jean says, Where? Where? Baloo says, On that bridge. Chris says, What the? Who are they? Jean says, Hick, don't worry. We'll solve your problem right away. Right, guys? Kilma says, We should help each other in times of trouble. Leave it to me, Jean says. Gancho goes, Yeah. Baloo says, Rest assured, you're in good hands. Oh my goodness, Chris says. Everyone told us that people here would help us if we were ever in trouble, but this is beyond our expectation. Kai says, Hey, you're still here. You haven't found it yet? Yes, I think I dropped it into the river. Jean says, That's easy. Everyone go find it. Bubble, bubble, goes Jean. People in this town are so unreal, Neeri says. I completely agree. They're diving! They're diving! Yo-Yo yells. They're floating as well. Whee! Crazy. These crazy people. Now what? Oh! The light bulb. Kai says, I found it! Hey guys! Is this what you were looking for? Yuya was handed the silver dagger. Chris says, Everyone, thank you very much. Kilma says, It was quick because everyone cooperated. Just tell us if you ever get into trouble again. Kai says, Drop by my house before you leave. I have something for you. Jean says, Pilgrims, you must have been through a lot too. Chris says, We must help each other in times of trouble. Jean says, Let's go back to the tavern and get another drink. They're extremely helpful, aren't they? Baloo says, I feel so good after helping people. Okay. Let's talk to these people. Samira says, I wish we had boars in this country, too. Sorry, only one per person. One jerky. Feel free to ask for help if you ever get in trouble again. I feel like backtracking and checking on these other people. Sled. Like, his name is Sled. About 20 years ago, the Moonlight Witch came here. She left a prophecy that Menorth would be hit by a great crop failure in the future. The prophecy came true. Okay. Well, I'm very sad your name is Sled. Mrs. Pinnica says, It's the next village, but that is quite a distance to Arud, so having them transport food by land is also difficult. Our only lifeline is the food brought by the regular liners and the catch from the sea. Okay. Oh, are you the mayor? Yeah, Mayor Laspa says, You must be pilgrims. Could you deliver this to the mayor of Arud? Our neighboring village, Arud, is also in a poor state, but they have ties with Negar Island and Tituta in the south. So, many traders must come to the village. We want to ask the mayor of Arud to send more letters to Neeri. Sorry, send more traders to Neeri. Could you deliver this letter to him for us? Yes. Chris says, We should help each other in times of trouble. You can trust us. We'll deliver it to the mayor of Arud. They received a Laspa's letter. Thank you. Sorry we can't offer you anything in return. But what comes around goes around. Life is like that. Well, we did get our dagger back, so... Make sure the letter gets to the village mayor of Arud. How rude. That's a sled, I guess. I don't know, Lana. I don't know. Oh, you found something? Not hungry, okay. Rumor has it that the bad harvest in Menarth is because of a curse by the Moonlight Witch. Jean says, would you like to join us? I don't think we're allowed to. Gancho says, I want more jerky. Hey, I haven't seen you in a while. Let's get some drink together. We're not allowed. We are minors. Alright. I've been over here. What'd you find? Cure potion. You found something else? A stimulant, good. Maybe we have 5 of those now? Yep. Those we can have more of. And at this, in this game, 10 items of a kind is all you can have. So I guess now we can go to the inn. Anything up here? No. Well, we can cut through the shop like this. Saji says, there's an old saying used by travelers, tired feet are caught by one shadow. Hurrying your way will only make your feet tired. Have a good rest here. Well, I want to talk to this person. Cup says, we haven't had many visitors lately, and the business is terrible. Oh, welcome. We have a room, but we can only offer you fish to eat. I must warn you, we don't even have rice or wheat. Well, could you let us stay for this? Yurio shows him the silver dagger. Oh, that must be the silver dagger. It's my lucky day. Pilgrims are welcome. There was no better luck these days. Well, it's actually not good luck for him because they need money. And now he's not getting money because we stay here for free with the silver dagger. I'll give you extra service. All right, I'll let you use the bed in the back. We can get some rest here. How about not yet? I mean, we don't need to rest. We're at full, I think. Sana says, are you pilgrims? Then you must be heading for the shrine in Tagura. It only takes you half a day to get to Tagura on a fishing boat from Arud. Thank you. But you should be careful. The fishermen in Arud are rough. Are they also rude? I mean, yeah, we're full. We don't need to sleep for anything. Kai says, I give you this. Kai handed a white stone to Yurio. What's this? It's called white stone. I want you to have it. It will help you along the way. This stone is said to have mysterious power. Are you sure we can keep it? Of course, Luna says. Please. Thanks. I'll treasure it. Now you don't have to worry about monsters anymore. Oh, really? Does this stop wandering monsters? Motion sickness pills, a surefire cure for seasickness. Laspa's letter for Mayor of Neeri to Mayor of Arud. Accessories. White stone, a beautiful stone found near the Crystal Lake, popular as a trinket. I don't want to drop it. So I wonder, how does it help us against monsters? If you ever get into trouble again, let me know. Luna says, what a cocky attitude, Kai. How is that a cocky attitude? That's a helpful attitude. I'm glad you found what you were looking for. Carry on your journey safely. Thank you. I guess we're leaving then. Tide Path. Your pet is in a bad mood. Your pet looks hungry. I don't think we had a place where we could buy pet food. I'll give you some agility food. Oh, hello. What is this? Lancargus snail. Speed up. Alright, so it was a Lancargus and a snail. I'll have her do her finishing move on the land, the light cactus on the Lancargus. It looks particularly nasty, doesn't it? Watch me work my magic. Light cactus. Bye-bye, Lancargus, whatever the hell you are. That's a fast snail. Oh boy. Takes care of one snail. Nine gold, somehow, from those things. Oh, this is a plant kind of thing. Mestizoa. Ah, you missed. Oh, the snail didn't miss. And neither did that snail. Finishing move. Oh no, this one. And that takes care of that one. And that one. Wait. I got it wrong. Yurio, attack this one. We'll attack our respective foes here. Oh boy. You leave her alone. Yurio levels up. Level 5. Sweet. So I'm not sure which way we're supposed to go. So we're going this way. Oh, it kind of meets up anyway. Fight these things. Oh, she's not quite there yet. Finish off the land car, I guess. Alright, she needs to get healed up. Uh-oh. Kill it! Work your magic. So up here is just... okay. So there's nothing back this way. Alright, so we're going this way, obviously. Let's take a look at the map. Nice, one-shotted. Wish I should have had her attack snail B. Just as well. Use some more healing. I guess we'll heal both of them up this time. What is this? Spirit magic. I should try that. Oh, wow. What of you? Hello.